Not Poverty Eradication Project for Lazy Women.
When I was growing up, if somebody got so rich in my village, there was always this perception, that one is a devil worshipper.
Where is the place for the grace of God in this?
We emancipate women. We empower our girls. But look at how the boy child, the male species, has been neglected.
What you're dealing with is a crisis. And the thing is that none of us is secure.
Well, I'm not saying that a man always has to have money. You can be broke. You know, you may not have the money for some time. Here, I'm talking about a laziness. I'm talking about a pattern of depending on the women in your lives to fund your exorbitant lifestyle.
I've always thought I was more special.
And so what again makes the girl special? So this, if we go on like this, we are going to raise entitled girls who become entitled women.
We do not have good relationship. Sometimes people get older, even if they have a family, they are so lonely in that family.
But grief is a natural response to loss. And so people at this time are going through pain. There's a lot of sadness, sorrow.
But now I had the anything and everything to talk about and yet deal also with his death. So I needed somebody to speak to me or to just give me an advice, every little thing.
If you have not been with us, we want you to go back and see the topics that we have discussed. Topics to do with, are you ready for marriage? Topics to do with single, satisfied, and sanctified.
So when you're single, you're still complete. It's a season.
Careful when you say you don't need a man. People say, I don't need a man, but are seriously struggling with pornography and masturbation. And at the same time say, I don't need a man. I don't need a man, but they're seriously struggling with vibrators.
I know many a times probably we focus more on the person with disability, and sometimes occasionally we forget the caregiver.
I did not necessarily have all the money, but by taking care of my sister, God has made sure that we are provided for.
The fact that you have someone who is an alcoholic, it's not you who is an alcoholic, but you are there to give support.
So if you can tolerate your mother or son, you can tolerate your husband better.
We've handled how to parent teens, and today in a very, very special way, and actually in a very strong way, we want to say no. No to child abuse.
More than 85, actually 90% and above of children, they're abused within their household.
And it's that person who is feeling the weight of the abuse. They may be a toddler, but they'll grow up with that, and knowing that at some point they were abused.
Every one of us has inherent dignity, which must be respected and protected. Now, that calls upon each one of us to know their rights.
So when one party has been assailed, do not blame anyone. Immediately roll out the plan of salvation.
Are you ready?
We need to be fair. We need to raise our sons to also know how to pick up after themselves. Because women are not rehabs for badly raised men.